Hey, you know headphones? Those sound makers you put on your head. There's a whole world of... Wait, no, please, where are you going? There's small ones, big ones, huge ones, wires, no wires, and of course, cheap and expensive.
Naturally, these more premium products are more suited to those with, shall we say, more refined tastes, such as myself. They're just the thing to help you sit back and relax with a fine beverage.
But what is a Hyad Pohonye? They're a lot older than you probably think. The ancestors of what we now call headphones first appeared in the 1890s, but weren't used for music at all. They were used by telephone switchboard operators, who had grown tired of faffing around with regular old telephone receivers all day while using their other hand to make the switches, and so special head-mounted devices were created to replace the conventional telephones. Oh! From there, they began to see use in wireless telegraphy, which would evolve into what we now know as radio. These headphones were part of the radio's high-voltage tube circuit, and as such, were definitely not consumer-grade products.
It wasn't really until the advent of the transistor radio in the mid-50s that headphones began establishing themselves as a somewhat common household item.
There was just one problem. These early consumer headphones were... how do I put this lightly? Bad. A certain group of hobbyists called audiophiles were largely not convinced, until the first pair of stereo headphones were invented in 1958 by Martin Lange in conjunction with one John C. Koss. I'm sure he stuck to his TV rental business for the rest of his life. But how do headphones actually work? I'm glad you asked, rhetorical pre-recording of me. The vast majority of headphones use a dynamic driver, which uses the exact same principle as regular old speakers. A cone of lightweight material, attached to a magnet, is moved back and forth via electromagnetism. The frequency at which it reciprocates produces airwaves of the same frequency, which our ears interpret as that one song you could have sworn sounded better in the club last night. Before I go any deeper, I just want to make it clear that you do not need expensive headphones to enjoy your music. Listen however you want. But especially if you consider yourself a bit of a muso, a good listening setup can give you a new appreciation for the music you love, helping you find little details about your favorite track that previously weren't that prevalent. It is at this point you may enter the realm of audiophiles, ostensibly a group of people dedicated to maximizing audio quality, but in reality are determined to blow out this month's wages on whatever promises to deliver them audio euphoria this time. Of course, you don't need to do that to get a pair of fantastic cans. So wade through the hype and look at the details. The difference between the cheap pair of earbuds you got free with your phone and a nice pair of premium headphones is mostly focused in three areas.
Comfort.
As most premium headphones are not designed with portability in mind, they are free to incorporate all sorts of head-friendly ergonomics. This often results in them being comically large, but that doesn't matter when you're alone in your room crying to a light that never goes out.
Build quality.
Better plastics, metal, and even wood in some cases means it just feels like a nicer product to use, not to mention even longer lasting.
Sound.
Rather than just being satisfied with producing sound, premium headphones often pay close attention to how the sound is being replicated, and what frequencies of sound are being given more or less emphasis. Certain headphones may focus on high-end clarity and sparkle, where others may have a massive bass shell for thumping beats. Others may attempt to be as neutral as possible. None of these are objectively better than the other. You just need to find what you like best. To exemplify what I mean by this, let's compare two different options. These are my headphones, a pair of AKG K702s. They're my rugged workhorse cans that I use every single day, and they haven't skipped a beat. In terms of comfort, these have it nailed down. The enormous fabric pads and self-adjusting headband mean I don't even know I'm wearing them sometimes. While they aren't made out of anything fancy, they're not made badly. I can't count how many times I've dropped these, and they're none the worse for wear. In terms of sound, they are starting to show their age a little bit as the competition has moved on, and while they lack a little bass for my taste, they still have a nice crispy airiness and soundstage that will outdo almost all regular headphones, especially on songs like the opening of Money for Nothing by Dire Straits. All in all, they've served me well, and as long as they continue to work, I don't see myself needing to upgrade anytime soon. Now just for fun, let's compare this secondhand Lexus to a Rolls-Royce. Richer Sounds, for some reason, have lent me these, a pair of Focal Clear MGs. These cost more than my monthly rent, and I'm in central London right now. Although, compared to the K702s, you can tell immediately. Everything you can touch on this headphone is either leather, metal, or the softest microfiber I've ever felt. Somehow, it manages to be only marginally heavier than the AKGs. It feels like a weapon, but not one to bludgeon someone with, more like a sneaky pocket dagger. To top it off, the pads have a ludicrous amount of cushioning. When listening to music, they lack a teensy bit of treble for me, but the speed and impact of bass and percussion and incredible instrument separation sold me instantly. Neil Peart's drum rolls on the intro of Xanadu by Rush have never sounded so good. So, as you can see, some headphones will focus more or less in any of these categories, and of course, some will not be so good in all of them, which is why you go to Richer Sounds and let the experienced in-store staff help you find what you want, and even try out different headphones in some of their demo rooms. They'll also be able to help you with any amps or DACs you may need. The DAC's job is to turn the digital information of the music on your computer into an analog signal that can be sent to your headphones, whereas the amp's job is to cleanly boost that signal for power-hungry headphones without adding any distortion. Beyond a certain point, a quality amp and DAC combo are required to get the best out of your cans, and with Richer Sounds, finding the right ones for you is a lot easier. So, if any of that got you pondering, maybe have a little mosey over to the Richer Sounds website, if you want. Maybe. Just a little peek. Quick little glance. Maybe think about going into the store as well. Lots of friendly staff. Look at the website.